We have to rescue a merchant ship crashed on a planet. The presence of perils, not wanting the presence to be known, fired upon the merchant ship. The merchants managed to make it on to the planet's surface, is now calling for help.
This should be an easy assignment. I think you can handle it while Kyle is away with Rush. Take a shuttle, land at the coordinates of the distress beacon, and pick up any survivors.
Kyle's away with Rush. I feel really bad for Kyle. And so we got... So since we did drain all the way, we can actually do something else. We don't want to really choke an asshole. Lightning may be okay, even though that's usually like not the best thing. Rage might be okay. Increases speed and increase in some and damage potential at the expense of health. I don't know. We could do that. I'm thinking of doing actually force protection. Because you decrease incoming damage from energy, physical, projectile, and explosive sources. So in those really tough situations, I reduce some damage. Force stasis, paralyze and living being or droid. Mind trick, confuse, or misdirect. Like, mainly the things you want to get are things that help you during the fights with other Jedi, kind of a thing. Jedi can absorb dark force power, force push, and force pull directed at them. This is actually also would be pretty good. Force absorption. Force insanity allows the Jedi to wreck the mind of an enemy. That also might be okay. We're gonna go for force protection, though. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. And we'll do the good old laser and this thing, and bring over the detonator mines.
Fabulous secret powers were revealed to me the day I held aloft my magic sword and said,
"By the power of Grayskull!"
Nice work, Jaden. Some rescue mission. Hello? Hello? Hey, you there.
Thank the Force you've come. This place is...
What was that? Maybe I can find what I need in the merchant ship.
In the merchant ship. Finger quotes. The merchant ship. Alright. I love the fact I could use that car alarm fucking sound in basically every episode. That's my mission for this LP. Anyways, Hey, you guys ever play the Floor is Lava? Yeah, the Floor is Lava in this. So have a good time. So we have to find a couple of ship parts. This is actually one of my favorite missions from this. It's pretty memorable, pretty fun. I actually like this one a lot. So I think this is not actually... he was down here, so...
Should be safe here.
Except it keeps making those noises, like something's like gonna fucking eat me. Well, something is going to fucking eat me, but you know. So we gotta find some parts. Alright, we got one part. Yeah, we don't need the health. So I think we can only bring back one part at a time. Don't quote me on that though. I'm pretty sure that's how it works. Maybe not. Maybe we should just like... try and see if it doesn't work that way. I don't know, you know, fuck it, we're already halfway there. And we can also see, you know what, we'll also see what parts we still need. Yeah, so we have the good old Jedi Academy runner. Actually, it's not even here. Alright, so we have a power converter somewhere. Fuck, where is it? Is it this one? No? That's this guy. Maybe it isn't just one part at a time. Says, oh yeah, only one part can be carried at a time. So it actually says that. So I actually remembered that. Because as I said, I've played this game before. So return a part in order to retrieve the other. Right, so we did that one. Dude, whenever we're on the floor, you see, like, the when I was on the sand, it wanted to come after me. It wanted my dick, so. I wanted Jen's dick. And now...
How am I gonna get over there?
So there's a little thing over there. Yeah, it's one of our parts that we need, so... Might as well use this for... So, the best way of doing this is, I guess, to just jump down and jump under those rocks.
This energy cell should work for the cooling unit.
So that, I mean, it's a great mission because it's not really about, like, facing any enemies. It's just kind of like a parkouring mission, which is actually, in its own right, very unique, I think. I actually love this one. I mean, you're going to be spending most of the game killing fucking whatever, so... here we go. Alright, so we have to get this, like, little fucking... I don't know what the hell that... Okay, so we got to get a nipple for our ship still, and, I don't even know what the hell that is. Fucking, like, a Cracker Jack, I guess. I don't even know what a Cracker Jack looks like, but if I knew what it looked like, it would probably be that. Alright, so we got to get the nipple next to the Cracker Jack. I should be in charge of naming everything in the future. Alright, so let's see around here. Because I've already been this way, technically. That, I think, is nothing new. Oh, no, that might actually be the Cracker Jack. It just occurred to me. Which means that the nipple is probably this way. Okay, so we can get on top of the ship now. Oh, there's the nipple. Alright, we gotta get to it from over there, so let's not go that way. Shit. Yeah, we gotta get to it from over there, which means that the... Yeah, that is the Cracker Jack. I guess there's something to do with the thermal detonators. Maybe they help in some way. Like, you can blow them up. Yeah, because I can bring that to me.
Just the power coupling I need.
Oh shit. Get me out of here. Of course that was the power coupling, that's what I said. That was the name I came up with. Copyright Mike Lott, 20 fucking XX. And we can make it back here pretty easily. And we know where the last one is, so we're pretty good. So obviously a super successful recon mission brought to you by Jen. And we need to put that in. Alright, now for the nipple. Get the fuck out of here. Now I'm guessing they're getting a little bit harder every time or something. Or maybe not. I mean, it's the fact that they force you to go back all the time, you know? Alright, you guys want to see what happens whenever I kill my- whenever I go in there on purpose and die? Alright. There you guys go. Wasted. Okay. No, I want to show you, like, what the actual threat was, because I've been actually succeeding at this so far. Cause you've been seeing it, but you don't really get the idea of what will happen if I stand on the lava. I mean sand.
I've gotta get over there.
Wait, why do I have 19 health? Oh, because I must have taken damage. Actually, I don't need that. What am I doing? Alright. I'm pretty sure if we just like oh shit. Oh, the rock is falling. Let's just fucking run. I think this is still safe. We should be okay. The fuck? Please. Alright, there was a, there's a little thing over here. With additional, there you go. I just need the health. So I kind of like this one because it's just like, there's nothing to fight. You know, and it's weird to say that, but like, it's the challenges through, as I said, finding objects and stuff in the level. I mean, it's a short one, but you know, it's all good. Maybe there's more to it, who knows.
That should do it. This crazy rock.
That's too bad about the merchants. Sounds like those sand burrowers must have gotten them all. Nasty critters. Glad you got back safe and sound. We'll let Coruscant know to mark the planet as hazardous.
Mark the entire planet as hazardous. Seriously? Come on, Kyle.
Nicely done, Jaden. I think you're ready for the next stage of training, but there's still another mission left if you choose to accept it. Remember, every mission is a chance to learn more about being a Jedi.
Yeah, so if you do the next mission, you get another Force Power, and obviously you get to actually, you know, like, do missions, so... But I don't know why I'd skip on the game. So... There's some activity by the Disciples of Regnos. However, it's not clear if it's really a Sith cult or the locals are just being paranoid. Go to Coronet and determine the truth.
I still have a few contacts in Coronet. We'll hit a few of the local cantinas and see what crops up. We'll also follow up with some of the people who reported this so-called cult activity.
Yeah, he does a little frown. Shit, that bothers me. Alright, now I could do this, which makes it like 50%, but no, let's do, maybe absorbing powers. Yeah, we can absorb power directly at them with no ill effects and gain some force power back as a result. That sounds pretty good. I'm gonna have to put those on some keys, though, but we'll deal with that later. We'll just take the sniper and this thing. As I said, we always get the laser gun, like, pretty early on, if we want it. Whatever the blaster rifle, stormtrooper shit, whatever the fuck you want to call it.
Then Jan punches the weak way right in the...
Can anyone hear me? We're under attack. Somebody's trying to blow up the tram.
The message is coming from that cargo tram down below. You take the tram. I'll take care of these ships.
Head towards the front and clear out each car. Keep the enemy in front of you so you don't have to worry about your flank.
Oh, that actually... That fucking returned on me and hit me. Fuck. So, if you were hearing the music right now, this actually had the really nice music to it. But we don't have the music, so... rip in pieces. I actually liked it in this one, but that would definitely get, like, me in trouble, so. It actually was one of my favorite ones, because it actually matched really well with what we're doing right now, which is, like, going extremely fast on a cargo tram. I bet I missed.
How do I turn that off?
Oh, probably something in here. If you do get the chance to play this game, as I said, I really like this level for that. I memorized it. It was very memorable to me for that reason. Alright. Alright, well, we turned off that. And now that's open. I think I'm going to actually bind those two keys I have somewhere, though. For Force Powers, I have, like, what is it called? I have, the fucking defense one, absorb, and the other one. I'll put that on, like, G and protect on V. Because that might be good. But we'll give it a try. It's actually it's supposed to make this easier for me, for, like, absorbing damage. Which, as you can imagine, with 50 health, would be pretty nice.
Oh dear, I'm doomed!
Okay. Come on, R2. Oh, shit. Can I force drain you? Of course I can't. Why would I be allowed to have fun? I actually, the animations are really spot on with this, like how she's kind of like holding her, like she's block. It's like very rainy, so obviously it's like, you know, I like the little detail. I like the details, you know. So obviously Kyle's having a grand old time fighting. In the Moldy Crow. They really fucked with the wrong guy. They didn't know. I like though, in the beginning cutscene, he was telling a story about Jen and him, and I'm literally Jen. Who the fuck's this guy? He's just reminiscing on our old times, you know? Oh, fuck. Well, you know, if you were just wondering how you could possibly miss with something that's a point-blank ability, I apparently have shown you the way. Oh, hey. I could kind of drain a little bit. Alright, later. Oh, yeah, no, you made your own, Alright, good. We did it.
Come get me, Jedi.
Alright, maybe we do want to go back there. Alright, yeah, we definitely do. Yeah, we're making our way back there. There was just someone, a living health pack, I guess. Let's just take out all these assholes first. Alright. The fuck? Apparently I need to, when I activate Force Protection. Harry got him. I wasn't aware actually how that worked. I figured it would be a nice thing for the fight. We go down here? No, we can't. We go over here? No, we can't do that either. Can't really do much of anything now, can we? Fuck. Oh, of course, there's glass there. Why would I be able to jump through glass? Alright, Jedi Academy intensifies, let's go. And I got him.
Get back here.
We're having an intimate moment, please. Fuck. You don't know the power of the- okay, he's dead. That is one of my favorite health draining abilities, and this guy is very unperceptive. But so am I, because I heard someone just trying to shoot me. I guess we're actually still okay. Well, we don't really need to get to the top here at all. You know, I like levels like this, because they're actually really creative how they make these, from a technical perspective. Because it's like, it's probably not really us moving, but it's probably the back of the scenery moving. Shit, I missed. Definitely didn't miss that time. Alright, I guess we just want to continue here. Oh, lightning, please.
Puck, do you read?
I read you, John.
Meet me at Station 6E.
Shit. Damn it. Best Jedi in the universe reporting in. Alright. I need some help. Doesn't even kill them all the way. I guess that guy was extra plump or something. Maybe we're here now. I don't know.
How can I get through there?
I got this one anyways. This one's actually really nice. Fucking piece of shit, I'm trying to block you. Alright, well, there's actually literally nothing over here. Oh, this is actually the way forward, so that is something that is here. I guess this brings the elevator up? Yeah, that would. You know, clearly they must have something related to this. That is not like just breaking glass. It seems so wasteful. Alright, some more crates over here. What the fuck?
Too easy.
Oh. That's Kyle.
What are you doing?
Alright. Maybe the sniper rifle wasn't the best thing to bring along for this mission. Shit. Or maybe it was the best thing, because it's actually working. What happens if I have a gun in third person? You know, it is working. You can't deny that. They're shooting me from over here somewhere. Fuck this shit. Oh good, I take like a crap ton of damage. You know, it just occurred to me, there is no back to tanks in this. We have not found a single back to tank, which is a staple. I guess only Kyle uses it. I guess it's unethical or something. Some illegal back to tanks. Okay, this was actually the best thing to bring along. What was I fucking thinking?
Kyle, there's a bomb on the tram.
An intruder. Disarm it quickly. You're about to enter a heavily populated area.
Alright, we need some health now. Oh. Whoa! Disarm it quickly, he said. Whoops. Like, he actually meant it. But, like,
Kyle, there's a bomb on the tram.
Disarm it quickly. You're about to enter a heavily populated area.
That wasn't so bad. Okay, mission accomplished.
Bad news, Jaden. The tram is speeding up. I think they're going to ram it into the station. You have to get to the control room and stop that train.
Come get me, Jedi.
What? So wait, that still stops me? So I use Force Absorb, and it still interrupts my shit. Oh shit. Did you see anything he says? So, like, we actually had to disable the bomb. This is not cheap. It's totally legitimate. And apparently, in this place, it's I get a 100% accurate shot. So, they're doing some sort of, like, weird Imperial Jihad, so, whatever. I didn't actually think it would blow up when I was fucking on this thing. But okay. Man. The future still isn't politically correct. Oh shit. Fuck. You know, fuck this shit, asshole. Actually, I should toss one of them off. Ah, whatever, you're not fucking with this shit. It's too much effort. Alright, dude, can you fucking wait? I like those combo attacks. Got him. such a great game. Alright.
That was too close.
Great work, Jaden. I took out those ships, so I think we're in the clear now.
excellent work on the tram. It's lucky you two showed up when you did. If that tram had exploded in the city, it could have killed thousands of people.
Something's come up. We need you back at the academy.
Oh, okay. No choice now.
Look, Jaden, I know better than almost anyone here that the dark side is tempting, especially in the middle of a fight. But you better watch it, okay?
Oh, he berates me, of course, on my force choices. Well, you know when he does this, I'm just gonna pick more dark side shit, you know that, right?
I have called you all here to relay some disturbing news. Someone sliced into my personal records and accessed some highly sensitive data about places where I felt a strong connection to the Force. Places like Cloud City, Hoth, and Biss.
What could they get from that besides a tour?
Something nasty.
I believe that the scepter Jaden saw was somehow used to drain the residual Force power from the Masasi Temple.
Drain the Force? How can anyone do that?
I'm not sure. But I've learned from the Jedi Holocron that devices were created in the past that could absorb and store Force energy.
Those people Jaden saw may have discovered some way to harvest Force power with that scepter.
Which could be dangerous indeed.
So what are we going to do?
We'll have to investigate any locations from our records. That includes all of you students. Corrin, you're going to Wayland. Kyle, I need you to look at the Valley of the Jedi.
Finally, some real action!
Why would they be stealing Force power?
I don't know. You worry too much, Jaden. I bet that these cult guys can't take on a Jedi.
Well, we're not Jedi yet. We're just students.
You may be just students, but you're both well on your way. So don't rush it.
Jaden, I'm sending you to Hoth, where I had a vision of Obi-Wan Kenobi. I imagine there was a pretty strong aura there. Rosh, I'm sending you to the remains of the planet Biss. It's very remote, so I doubt the cult has been there. Don't stay too long. The Imperial Remnant may still be operating in the area.
No problem.
That's everyone, then. May the Force be with all of you.
Good luck! Call me if you need any help.
Alright. Good old loadout.